blackout. I save my documents because I never trust any. It's called blackout. And I didn't take because I take. Yeah. There's someone. Thank you. Thank you. Applause for him. There's someone that looks at my screen. Actually, he's not sleeping already. Yeah, I will stop after that. I think you learned a lot about queues. Did I put 10 now? Ah, 10, yeah. Okay, blackout. It's a good time. And no, it's working. There are people who are using it in real life. Because in a city installation, you don't want to go there often to change the things. You don't necessarily have a wireless connection to put a team viewer. So having a calendar, that's what you think. That's what you think. Let's see if I click now. There's another mistake, maybe. If you look at an ICS file, it's interesting. You can read what's in there. And timestamp, begin. Twelve 02. Ah, that's another event that's in my stuff. And there's a start time. I don't know what mistake I've done. In fact, that's the first time I tested with the Apple stuff. But someone has been using it. So it is supposed to be working perfectly. I'm sure it works with Google Calendar. I suppose there's a mistake in this one. Because maybe UTC time stuff. Anyway, I will look at that. No, laugh. Okay, so use Google Calendar for now. That's a beta version. I will look what's going on in 4.1 beta version. Maybe we did some regression, some UTC stuff. I will look at that. So I wanted to show you, yes, how to program with queues, and I hope you learned a lot from this. Sending an SMS, then how do you get back the data? You should get back the data, then you need something to listen to, an HTTP to.
And
send OSC to trigger. We don't have that's something that needs to be customized. There's no. Maybe there are services to get a stream of data from a SMS number. I have no idea. I've not been into that. I suppose there are a lot of possibilities with Macs or stuff like this to get SMS data and to trigger to send an OSC control that will trigger a queue in ManMapper. So the queues and like the Firmata and like the, all the shader parameters, all sliders and parameters of ManMapper can be controlled by right clicking on it and choosing add control. And then there is keyboard, MIDI, DMX, OSC, audio, and then the ManMapper category with BPM, Firmata, and other things. And Ableton link here also. And so with OSC, which is a network protocol, you can communicate locally or via the network easily. So very simple protocol, and that allows to transmit floating point values, strings, on off things, true false, integer values. So it's nice. It's better than MIDI, because if you want to do some smooth transitions, you have floating point numbers. You can send texts. To be written on the text surface, but you can also do queues with different images. That's it for me. If no more questions.
Is there a question from the internet? No? Okay.
Sleeping.
Okay, so now we... Can you hear me? So now we are moving to the minima section of this masterclass. I will switch to my computer. Can we see my computer screen? Thank you. So a quick recap of the minima 4.0 release back in last September. We did a masterclass last year at Mapping Festival. And here's a quick recap of the features we introduced with Minimat 4. So we have new video surfaces that support masks, feathering, circles, and all the nice features Mathieu showed you on the surfaces in Annapur that are not now supported in Minimat as well. We added a video performance mode that enables you to play video up to 1080p 30 on Minimad if you play on a TV or on a straight projection. We added video theme groups, so it's a way to put a group name on each Minimad you want to export, and then only a Minimad with the same group will synchronize. So let's imagine you have a big venue with different Minimad setups and can all share the same network, but being synchronized within their own groups. And you can also target them and control them by groups. So it's really nice for big installations. We've added Minimad Light audio playback. So now you can attach an audio file to your Minimad recording, and it will be played back by the Minimad, either by the audio jack, or you can plug a USB sound card with multiple channels. So we've tested it with up to 8 channels. So you can do a spatial audio with your LED content using a single Minimad. We've also added Bonjour Nickname, which enables you to give a specific name to each Minimad you use. So by using OSC or the Minimad controller, you can know exactly which Minimad you target. And it's way easier than recording the IP addresses and so on. We also unified the OSC commands of the Minimad, because in version 3 there was commands for Minimad Lite, commands for Minimad Video, but because we wanted to have a single way, like the Minimad controller, to control either Minimad Video or Minimad Lite, we unified all those commands. And finally, we introduced a new module in MadMapper, which is Minimad controller, and that gives you access to all the features of a selected Minimad or a selected Minimad group within MadMapper using OSC protocol. But now, so if you want more details about all those features, they were presented in the last masterclass. So check out on YouTube for the masterclass casting. So now we are close to releasing MadMapper 4.1. With Minimad 4.1. It's actually in beta. You can download the beta on your space. I think it will be out in a few days or weeks. So the idea with Minimad 4.1, so we listen to the feedback we received on the support, and we read the forum, and you can really ask questions on the forum. We go there daily and try to answer and fix your problems as quickly as possible. So we've listened, and there were some small details that had to be fixed and improved in order to get the most of Minimad 4. So I will list you and show you all the changes we made in this version. So first one, a little one, is a new option called Wait for Display in Minimad Video. So if I would, here I have a small mapping I made, and I want to simulate an export. So I go in export, Minimap, export on to Minimad. In advanced section, you will find a new setting that's called wait for display. And the idea is that you can ask the Minimad to wait for the like video projector to turn on, because if you on morning you turn everything on, sometimes depending on your device, the video projector can take more time than the Minimad to start. And by adding this feature, you can make sure that Minimad won't start the playback before the video projector is ready, which could cause some resolution problem, etc. And it's it can be checked or unchecked because based on the feedback we received, some devices won't like this option, or it will work better with or without. So now you can check it or uncheck it. Next, we add network configuration settings. So in both Minimad Video and Minimad Lite. So before, there was no way to precisely control the IP and the network settings of your Minimad. So your Minimad Video was either getting IP from your local network, so your local DHCP server, or it was itself taking random IP addresses and make sure that the synchronization worked okay. But by using that, you could not know the IP addresses you had to target to control them via OSC, for instance. So now we make the network configuration available in the export section. So by default, it's automatic and it can be switched to manual. And then you can specify an IP address and a network mask for each individual Minimad you export to. And it's the same thing with Minimad Lite. So if I export to Minimad Lite, you will see that these settings that was there for only for ArtNet configuration, because if you're using ArtNet or SACN, you need to specify an IP address. Now you can specify it as well if you're using a DMX controller like this one. So it's much more convenient to know exactly what IP you're giving to your devices, so then you can target it using any OSC OSC software, control software. Then we've added the shutdown, a way to shut down your devices directly using all the controls we have, so you can do it as it was already possible but not documented by pressing on the Minimad buttons. You can do it with a computer keyboard. Now we can do it with the Minimad controller and OSC protocol. So now if I take my Minimad controller, I've made one for each Minimad that's running. So there's one Minimad video, one Minimad light. And if I show you the output, so that's on the screen, the output of my Minimad video. I can turn on shutdown and ask for, is it Minimad video? No. Doesn't work. What happens? Shutdown. Ah, offline. Ah, there's a network problem. What happens? Ah, il est branché. Ah, non, non, non. Okay, so it doesn't work with the Minimad controller for some reason. Ah. Okay, it's back online, it seems. No, it doesn't work. Yeah, there's a problem with the network, it seems. But anyway, I'll show you. So by pressing keys on the Minimad, you can and hold them, you can shut down. By using OSC controller, you can shut down, and I will show you that more in details. And you're supposed to be able to do it as well with the Minimad controller, and it was working before, and now we have problem. I don't know what happens.
That's problematic. It's coming back and it's going out.
Anyways. And we also made a new unified TouchOSC layout that I can show you. So on my phone, I'm running TouchOSC software, and I've loaded a layout that I made for Manmapper 4, which combines all the previous layout we've released for Minimat. So the first tab corresponds to mimics the buttons of the Minimat. So anything you do mimics. It also doesn't work. Okay. So everything I do on my phone. So my phone is wirelessly connected using this wireless router, and which is connected to both Minimats via Ethernet. So remotely, without cable, I can control all the functions of the Minimat. So here, yes. So here I can enter edit mode, and wirelessly, while being in the venue, I can adjust my mapping, or I can adjust my colors, my brightness, and so on. I can change media. Next tab is playback tab. So here you can find everything around media playback. So I can change media, I can change the luminosity of my mapping, I can restart my media, I can pause, and so on. And the third tab is called system, and for now it only contains a shutdown function. So when the day is over, the party is over, you can gently shut down your Minimat wirelessly using your phone and TouchOSC. Yes. Yes, it will be actually there are layouts, two layouts for Minimat 4.0 on the your space, and this one is available in the beta section for now in your space as well. So you can download it and try it right now, as well as Minimat 4.1, Manmapper 4.1. So we try to get all those functions, including gentle shutdown, to all control options. And I'll explain that the reason for that in the next section of this presentation. And the idea with all that is that now, using all the features that Mathieu showed you, like the queues and the scenes and so on, and the Minimat controller, you can actually schedule your Minimat setup, so tens of Minimats, video walls, and LED fixtures driven by Minimats all across a big venue. You can then schedule them using scenes and queues from a little computer using Manmapper, for example. So it can be a really small PC, a laptop, only using the Minimat controller and the scenes and queues. And by doing that, and using the queue scheduler, calendar scheduler, you can schedule all venue running Minimat for your LEDs and your video projection and your video walls. So that's very convenient. Of course, you're not forced to use the Minimat controller, because Minimat controller is using OSC. You can use other scheduling software like Vezer on Mac or QLab on Windows. Yes. QLab.
QLab is Mac also.
It's Mac also. So, but there are several OSC.
Also with the Mac, the Mac.
Yes. Stuff. So there are a lot of software that sends out OSC that you can use to control your Minimat setup in your venue. Then we'll move back to I think a really good section for your success in making your Minimat setup run for months without maintenance. So the idea is that you set up your minimas in your venue, and we want it to run without any maintenance for months. So you just start them on the morning, or you just let them play for without shutting them down, and it has to run. It cannot crash. So first of all, before contacting the support, read the user manual, because we made a lot of effort. By the way, the manual for the Minimad, as for the other manuals, is in the help menu of ManMapper, Minimad User Guide. And in there, you have a lot of details on the different dialogues and different features and the setup you can make, all the function for all keys, computer keys, all the OSC commands you can send from OSC software. So at the very end of the user guide, you'll find a new section that we made based on the feedback we received. So how to turn off the Minimad and to activate your Minimad. So we try to detail as much as we could all the things that people are asking, like what are the latest status. So if something's wrong, you can go to the troubleshoot section of this. It's the very last page of this user guide, and learn about the LED status. So if something goes wrong, you can go in there and learn what's going on. So read the manual, please. Then the most common, I think, problem we have, we don't have many problems on Minimad, but sometimes people get their SD card corrupted, and we have to tell them to flash it with a new image, and we really want to avoid that because it's the most common problem. And this problem is caused when you will just cut off the power of a Minimad, and it's actually saving something on the SD card. So it's writing on the SD card, and you just turn it off without using the shutdown function. And by doing that, you can corrupt the SD card, and then it won't start, or it won't work as expected. So for that, we have a few advice. If you can, use the shutdown function, because now it's there, it's in on all control modes, so you should use that, and you can schedule it in the queues and so on. If you can't, because the venue, you don't have people to do that, and you will simply turn off the power of the old venue, you have to just make sure to use the right settings to avoid the Minimad to write on the SD card. So by default, when you do a new project with Minimad 4.1 and you don't touch the settings that we have in the export section, the media settings, it won't write anything to the SD card, so you're safe. So if you just put media on your Minimad, export your mapping, then you're safe. You can just unplug the Minimad and nothing will go wrong. But there are a few settings that you have to take care of, like if I go to Minimad Recorder and export here, you can see that there's this option that is off by default. It starts with the latest play sequence, which means that if you shut it down and turn it off, it will start where it left off. But that means that every time it will change the media, it will have to save what media it's playing on the SD card. And if by any chance you would just cut the power when it's writing on the SD card, you could corrupt it. So we listed in the user manual all the functions that you should avoid using. Where is it? Yes, turn off the Minimad. So you choose avoid changing media, changing the master luminosity, audio, volume, playback mode. So there's only a few things you should avoid to being able to cut the power like that, or shut down the entire room, and you will be safe. Then we also have, it doesn't happen often, but we have feedback on the SD card corrupt, but I did everything right, I don't understand. And we actually witnessed witnessed cases where the Minimad was put next to a video projector in a box, so it was getting really hot, and the SD card can be easily corrupted when it's too hot. You cannot do anything about it using standard SD card, but you can use, if you're forced to do so, or if you, the Minimag is operating in a very warm environment, like in the desert or whatever, then you can use industrial grade SD cards that will actually be selling in a few weeks on the shop soon, and no specific date. But we'll be seeing industrial grade SD card that can it's guaranteed to last for a certain amount of time and a certain temperature, high temperature, and so on. So that will be soon available on the shop. And another advice I always give to people doing a Minimad setup that will last for months, etc., that is turned off and turned on every day, is always make a clone of your of each SD card you put in your running Minimad. So you make a clone using Apple PBaker on the Mac or Win32 Disk Imager on Windows. So you do everything, you export, it works. You just take them off, take them out of the Minimad, make a clone file, and make a clone on another SD card. And if something goes wrong, I don't know, something goes wrong and the SD card is corrupted, is overwriting, I don't know, then you can just swap the SD cards and your show will restart, and it will only take a few seconds. If the playback doesn't start, so let's say here my setup is kind of a minimal setup. So I have a Minimad video, a Minimad light. Minimad light is just driving this little LED bar. They are both connected to this Ethernet and on the wireless, small wireless adapter, so I can control this wirelessly. But let's say I made an export with Minimad light and nothing happens when I turn it off. I turn it on. I don't know what happens, etc. I don't have any feedback. I check on the LEDs. The LEDs don't blink. Okay. So a good practice is to plug your Minimad to the HDMI screen, and then you have you can have feedback. Actually, I can show you. You can have feedback. Yeah, so that's the feedback you get by plugging the HDMI screen on the Minimad light. So it will tell you the version, it will tell you the IP address, and actually, if you're and it happens more than you can think, that the Ethernet cable is wrong or it's wrongly plugged or anything, that will be displayed there. So it will say Ethernet is disconnected and not playing. So we try to give as much feedback on this on-screen display as we can, so you can learn what's going wrong with the setup. And it's the same for the Minimad video, actually. If I go to my Minimad video feed here, and I press on blue and yellow on the Minimad itself, or if I press D on the USB wireless keyboard, I can have the OSD on-screen display appearing and showing me also the IP address and so on, if the Ethernet is disconnected and so on. I think that's about it for this Minimad presentation. Thank you. Is there any question from the public on the internet? No? Okay, so Benoît answered on the web. Benoît. Oui, Benoît.
So Benoît is the guy in the user support, a lot of things around Manmapper, Minimad, Modulate,
all from Geneva.
Well, again.
Oh, now it's back online. Okay. So that's about it. I don't know if anyone has something to say more. So enjoy the mapping festival.
No questions?
No question. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening.
Bye bye.